Good morning. This is the Tofu Robots channel. Recording this on my old Pixel 7 Pro, and I am in outside Cairns, Australia. Just wanted to do a quick video. Every time we come to Australia, we rent this Toyota Land Cruiser Prado. I believe this is a 2023 GXL model, and we're just going to do a quick walk around. We do not have these in America, but they are very similar, if not the same, as the Lexus GX460, I believe. But this is what you get in Australia. And we're just going to randomly look at stuff. Try to make it brief, though. There's the wheels. I think these are 17-inch. It's a 265, 65R17. Got your side steps, power folding mirrors, roof rack. Here's what the rear looks like. You got the rear reverse sensors, spare tire. There's the Land Cruiser Prado badge there, Toyota badge. I do not see the trim badge anywhere. Let's take a look underneath. It does have a big old fuel tank and secondary fuel tank. All right, let's take a look inside. There's the signature side open tailgate. I don't think this glass comes down. It's just one piece. Got a nice emergency door handle there. Guess you got some storage for recovery or your jacks and stuff, I'm assuming. Again, this is a rental car, so I haven't really dug into it that much. This does have three rows. The third row is right here. And I don't know how this comes out. We don't need a third row, so I keep it. Actually, it was already folded in when we picked up the truck. It does take up about 4 inches of floor space, but if you don't pay attention, you don't even notice. Got a cup holder. And here's a 220 volt, 100 watt Australia spec outlet. Let's look at the rear seats. These are soft touch plastic. This is cloth here. This is just plastic. There's your hard plastic cup holders. Just standard soft cloth seats. What I do like about these seats, if you really don't need your leg room or need more space for the rear passengers, it does move. I believe the brand new Land Cruiser Prado or 250 series, at least in America it's just called Land Cruiser, these are not adjustable. They're just stuck in place. What else we got? This is just climate control. Yeah, you got your cigarette lighter power. There's nothing here. Got some nice rubber floor mats on the ceiling. There's no moonroof or anything. You do have vents. Now we're on the passenger side. Got your soft touch, your glove box, No passenger power seat, but your standard back and forth. Center console here, armrest. It does not go forward. And we have our off-road features, center locking differential, rear locker, downhill assist, stability control off, and start and second gear. And then we can switch between high and low gear. Cup holders, shifter, driver's side. We have our auto high beams, windshield washing, looks like. And I don't know what that smoky thing is on the lower left. And we got your hood and your gas fuel cap, fuel cover release. And this uses diesel fuel. Start it up. Got that nice diesel sound. And what do we got here? We got our sat nav. Got various options here. I haven't messed around with any of this. So these are the phones of the previous rental car customers. So I don't know how much information it sucks from your phone, but I usually erase my phone before I return the car, if I even sync it up. So it looks like at least three iPhones and not an iPhone. I don't know who Whit Sunday is. Somebody's got a Motorola Edge, and Kate's got a Samsung 21 FE. All right, let's go back home. Menu, what do we have for setup? Bluetooth audio phone, voice, vehicle, what we got here? Oh boy. So I'm not gonna go through all this, but in case you're wondering, kinda interesting. Let's go back. All right, you get the picture. Any apps on here? No. Okay. Here's the fuel door. As I said, it does use diesel. And under the hood, what a concept. It's got struts to lift the hood. Unlike the new American Land Cruiser, where it's just got the little stick to keep the hood up. So this is a diesel. I think it's 2.8 liter diesel with a turbo. Lots of space inside. Nice and clean. All right. And that's it. That's just a brief walk around of the, I believe, a 2023 Australia spec Land Cruiser Prado. They don't make them anymore. They don't sell them here anymore. I went on the Toyota website and says, nope, wait until the end of 2024 for the new model, which will be the 250 series. So, what do you think? That's it for now. Thanks for watching.